బీజేపీ కార్యాలయంలో కేంద్ర మంత్రి స్మృతి ఇరానీ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. లైట్ త్వర చూద్దాం.
కేబుల్ సర్టిఫికేషన్ బిట్వీన్ ఎంఐఎం అండ్ ది చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ అండ్ హిస్ ఫ్యామిలీ సీక్స్ టు బ్లీడ్ ది కాఫర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టేట్ అండ్ దిస్ గ్రేట్ సిటీ seeks to depend on illegal immigrants for their political gain. The Bharatiya Janata Party promises this iconic city clean, transparent governance, a governance model as has been espoused by our esteemed Prime Minister, underlined by the ethos of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. I now leave the floor open for questions. If you can, ma'am, just indicate your name and your publication, we'll be a great help.
You said about the Rohingyas, there was a question from the MIM. If there were truly Rohingyas settled in the city, why did Amit Shah not take any action?
Madam, as you are aware,
and if there are such Rohingyas, why doesn't the BJP produce a list?
Today, in my opening statement, I have elucidated about a local TV channel. I would like to add news made available by a national TV channel of MIM leaders using their own letterheads to have illegal Bangladeshi immigrants enrolled in the voter list. Given that law and order is a state issue, as I have said, a conscientious government which is dedicated to the rule of law should have immediately begun investigations on the basis of these two terrible, scathing affirmations of the use of illegal immigrants for political gain by the MIM and the TRS. The fact that the state government has not undertaken any stern action against MIM leaders, as has been indicated by the media itself, is a testimony to their corrupt collaboration.
Ma'am, there is another question for you, if I could ask one.
Please, ma'am.
The MIM says, why talk about Rohingyas and illegal immigrants now? Why doesn't the BJP talk about development? And KTR says that if there is a surgical strike, why can't the government talk about surgical strike on the ineffective economy? If not, the people are going to do a surgical strike on the ineffective government.
What is your answer? Madam, two answers is what you are hoping to get from me. The Bharatiya Janata Party has taken a consistent stand in Parliament and within our organization against illegal immigrants. We have consistently maintained the position that we need to protect the rights of every Indian citizen, the rights of institutions and administrations to ensure that the taxpayers' money goes to the deserving Indian who is a part of this great land. For the MIM or the TRS, in an unholy alliance to espouse the cause of illegal immigrants tells you what their political identity tells you. To say that the Bharatiya Janata Party has just brought up the issue of illegal immigrants would be to shy away from the truth that the Bharatiya Janata Party has consistently maintained that this great land of ours rightfully belongs to every Indian citizen. Thereby, we need to ensure that the rights of Indian citizens are protected
against illegal immigrants. Hence, the fact that the TRS and the MIM will not stand by the average Indian, but choose to stand by illegal immigrants so that they can politically gain, is shameful. As far as the TRS's statement that surgical strikes be ensured on issues such as economy, as the Minister of Textiles, I can proudly say that it has been my distinct privilege to ensure that under the leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister, Korean investment comes to the state to the tune of 920 crores. Under the National Technical Textiles Mission, which was announced in this year's budget, a 1,000 crore capacity production of technical textiles is being set up in Telangana. Why only the entire state? If you look at this great city of Hyderabad, under the Pradhan Mantri's Kaushal Vikas Yojana, 63,000 youngsters have been skill trained. Over 10,000 have already received their placements. What is disabilitating is that under the Sankalp Yojana, this Yojana which actually supports livelihood program, the state government is yet to submit its detailed DPR to the government of India. On one hand, you deny poor children vaccination. On the other hand, you deny an opportunity to the youngsters in this state to benefit from livelihood programs. And also, madam, an informed journalist like you knows that the Telangana government is also shying away from programs such as Ayushman Bharat, so that the poorest of the poor that is needed to be helped from over 1,300 illnesses with a yearly cover of 5 lakhs is being denied to the people of Telangana and especially Hyderabad only because the TRS wants to politically gain. Like I said, and I reiterate, madam, when I speak of the corrupt connivance and collaboration with MIM and TRS, tell me, madam, is it possible for 75,000 illegal immigrants only in one city if these two political parties had not joined hands? Yes.
communication enough. But the TRS and the MIM together want to ensure that illegal immigrants have a right on this iconic city and not the citizens of the family.
We will always remember it. He knew all of us of the past, personally well. And,
it is the people of this country and this great state who gave up their lives so that this state could find its own place in the destiny of India. Instead of honoring that sacrifice, MIM and TRS chooses to stand with illegal
immigrants. सवाल पूछा गया उसका जवाब पूरा शायद नहीं आया. असदुद्दीन ओवैसी ने कहा कि 970 किलो वर्ग किलोमीटर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर एरिया पर जो है वो चाइनीज आर्मी ने ऑलरेडी कब्जा कर रखा है, वहां क्यों नहीं एक्शन होता, वहां क्यों नहीं बात होती. तो क्या ये बात इसमें कितनी सत्यता है कि 970 किलोमीटर एरिया में चीन ने कब्जा कर रखा है, और क्या उस सिलसिले में गवर्नमेंट की पॉलिसी लेवल पे क्या कुछ इस तरह का आप कुछ रोशनी डाल पाएंगी?
मैं इतना ही कहना चाहूंगी कि जब उनके पास हैदराबाद की नाकामियों का जवाब ना हो तो निश्चित रूप से वो इस प्रकार का प्रश्न प्रस्तुत करेंगे, ये जानते हुए कि भारत की सरहद पर भारत की फौज इतना दम रखती है कि दुश्मन देशों को वो बराबर हिंदुस्तान की ओर से जवाब दे सके. आज जो मैंने आपसे प्रश्न इस पूरी प्रश्नावली और इस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के माध्यम से रखा वो ये कि एक तरफ हमारे देश की सरहद पर हमारी फौज लड़ रही है ताकि दुश्मन देश हमारे देश को कोई हानि ना पहुंचाए, दूसरी ओर इस शहर में ऐतिहासिक हिंदुस्तान का मुद्दा जवाब हिंदुस्तान की आवाम को हैदराबाद की आवाम को देना पड़ेगा. दूसरी बात जो मैंने कही कि आपने 35,000 परिवारों को डेल्यूज के वक्त संघर्ष के लिए अकेला छोड़ दिया, 80 लोग मर गए और अब तक प्रदेश की सरकार ने अपना फाइनल मेमोरेंडम नहीं दिया. क्या इस प्रदेश में और विशेषतः इस शहर में यह संभव है कि डेल्यूज का एक बहुत बड़ा कारण है इलीगल इंक्रोचमेंट, वो 75,000 इलीगल इंक्रोचमेंट बिना एमआईएम और टीआरएस की जुगलबंदी के, क्या यह संभव था? तो आज अगर शहर को आपको विकास के पथ पर डालना है तो आपको सुनिश्चित करना होगा कि क्या ये शहर के साथ नाइंसाफी नहीं कि गरीब बच्चों का टीकाकरण ना हो.
Or skin, or dress, or food. We think that when you have a battle, remind me.
विक्रम के लिए अपना डिटेल प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट तक नहीं देते.
तो
मैंने जो आज अपने इस पूरे वक्त तक दोबारा दोहराती हूँ. एक कन्वीनियंट करप्ट कोलैबोरेशन है एमआईएम और टीआरएस के मध्य में. हैदराबाद की जनता उस कन्वीनियंट करप्ट कोलैबोरेशन को समझती है और इसीलिए हम इस बात का यहाँ पर विश्वास व्यक्त कर रहे हैं कि हैदराबाद की जनता इस चुनाव में अपना आशीर्वाद भाजपा को देगी.
मैडम, दिस इज लोकेश फ्रॉम न्यूज एक्स.
यस,
Obviously, have challenged you openly to show 1,000 names of illegal Rohingyas or anybody.
I am appealing to you again that if there are reports and especially the audiovisual reports given by a national channel and a local channel. On the local channel, a Rohingya Muslim is openly declaring gratitude for enrolling him in the voter list. And he expresses his gratitude not only to MIM, he expresses it to the MIM and the CM of Telangana. In the national channel, the media itself has brought to fore how MIM political leaders on their letterheads are ensuring that illegal Bangladeshi immigrants also find a mention in the voter list. You tell me, sir, law and order being a state issue, would a conscientious government not start an investigation? Why is it that the TRS kept quiet on it? Because they seek to politically gain from their alliance from the MIM
and politically gain by using illegal immigrants and having them illicitly brought to the voter list. Anybody who wants to ensure that the dream that we had for Telangana is fulfilled would have made sure that the rights of the citizens of Hyderabad and Telangana are protected and not the rights of illegal immigrants.
Ma'am, this is Aneri from Republic TV.
Yes.
Can you speak about love jihad, the law which is being put forward? AIMIM Chief Asaduddin Owaisi has also given out a statement in that regard and said that BJP is violating the rule of love jihad. And what do you have to say?
Violating the rule of?
Section 14 and 21.
If you read the tenets and the pillars on which the Indian Constitution stands, it disallows fraudulent and illegal coercive action against a woman. If a state government takes within the ambit of the Constitution steps to ensure that women are not criminally and fraudulently coerced into a relationship, should the right and the protection of that woman not be supported by Indians across the country, illegal, irrespective of our political ideology? When the intent of the state within, I said repeatedly, under the ambit of the Constitution is to ensure that fraudulent and criminal coercion is dissuaded so that the rights of women is protected, my appeal is that we look at this issue from that perspective.
But then he says that BJP is violating the law and so what do you have to
say? Does the law provide for women to be fraudulently exposed? Does the law provide for women to be fraudulently and criminally coerced? It does not.
RJD chief Lalu speaks to BJP MLA Lalan Paswan and he asked him to be absent for the speaker elections and he also offers him ministerial berth and what would you like to say, ma'am, on this? And
I was hoping to concentrate only on the GHMC. You would like me to answer on from China onwards to Bihar. I'm happy for that privilege to be given to me. The election has been decidedly lost by the RJD. The fact that they would like to explore illicit methods to want to be in power is the very reason why the people of Bihar rejected them. Bihar has reasserted its belief of Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas, and as a Bharatiya Janata Party Karyakarta, I express my public gratitude to the citizens of Bihar.
क्या
मुझे इस बात को एंडोर्स करना चाहिए, समर्थन करना चाहिए कि करप्शन के खिलाफ एक्शन हो? हाँ, मैं निश्चित रूप से करप्शन के खिलाफ एक्शन हो इसकी पक्षधर हूं। क्या मेरा यह पक्ष होना चाहिए कि ओल्ड सिटी में विकास हो? हाँ, मैं इस बात की पूरी तरह से पक्षधर हूं कि ओल्ड सिटी में विकास हो, विशेषतः जब विकास से वंचित ओल्ड सिटी को इसलिए लिखा गया है ताकि MIM के कार्यकर्ता वहां के लोगों का पॉलिटिकल फायदा उठा सके। क्या मैं इस बात की पक्षधर हूं कि GHMC में एक ट्रांसपेरेंट गवर्नेंस मॉडल प्रतिस्थापित होना चाहिए? बिल्कुल, मैं उसकी पक्षधर हूं और इसीलिए जनता से अपील करती हूं कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी को अपना समर्थन, अपना आशीर्वाद और अपना वोट वो दे।
थैंक यू।
Ma'am, last question.
Dhanyawad.
There's a one question.
Yes.
You are alleging that Asaduddin Owaisi had links with the terrorist, and your party people are alleging that. Why don't you arrest Asaduddin Owaisi like Barwar Rao arrested in the Hyderabad city?
I would like to reaffirm and reassert, sir, as I have said in the beginning of this press conference, the two press reports that I have here brought to your notice, one by the national press and another by a local channel, are a scathing testimony to the collaboration between the MIM and the TRS with regards to ensuring that illegal immigrants find a place in the voter list. State being in charge of law and order, why is it that TRS has not taken action against such media reports after they have come to the fore in the interest of the citizens of Hyderabad? That again, I reiterate, is a certification that the unholy alliance between MIM and TRS is so that the coffers of Telangana and especially the iconic city Hyderabad can be bled.
Ma'am, last
thank
last
you.
Question, ma'am.
Thank you.